this morning. It wasn't that bad.
Hey, Mr. Johnson.
Hey.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good.
Yeah. Was
it quotes and stuff?
It was quotes, and then there was like two quotes on the back that were like, you have to get them before and
there's no calculator on any of the tests or on just part of it?
One of them was like
Whole test.
Whole test is no calculator.
Okay.
Yeah, I do need you guys to put your phones and smartwatches up. Sorry, I didn't have that on the board.
Provide me when you take your test.
I think we got our...
Okay, guys, I need your phone, smartwatches put away on the side of the room, please. Also, this is your last chance for any points from Unit 4. Whether that's the test review, you didn't get that put in Google Classroom, late work, incomplete work from Unit 4, this is your last chance. Not later this period, not later today, before we start the test. You don't need it during the test, so... If you didn't put it in Google Classroom, I need it in the basket with your name on it.
Half the points come from multiple choice, half comes from FRQ. pointed it out to you before you get started, because if I was you, I would start with the FRQ, then do the multiple choice, and then come back and give the FRQ a second. Typically, you guys don't put equal amount of time into the process. Usually, you spend most of your time on the multiple choice. But again, multiple choice is only half the practice. Again, I will bring the stapler on in just a moment, but I want to get to your testing too. Yeah. You're going to staple them, but it doesn't matter. So if you need any scratch work, the back page, the back of the back page should be blank. So feel free to do any scratch work for the multiple choice there. For your response, you probably should not be doing scratch work there because I need to see your work for that.
Everybody just have the stapler.
Yes, I'm sorry, that should be 1, 2, 3. Yeah, sorry, if you have the blue test, question number 3, those 3 things are supposed to be option 1, then option 2, then option 3. Word auto-corrected those.
What?
In the form, question 3. I'm not talking about that right now. I'm not going to be able to correct it. It's supposed to be 1, 2, 3. It just changed those numbers. Finished. There is a paper I'd like you to pick up as you turn your test in, and I want to talk about the last part as a group once we're all finished, that you are welcome to take the majority of time. All of this time should be a very good resource, a lot of time for 9 multiple choice and 1 FRQ, so please double work, check your work, consider rereading the questions, making sure you didn't miss part of the directions. Consider reworking the harder of the questions if you need to make sure you get the same answer.
I negative one? Is this like, it's not like, it's, this isn't like a coordinate negative one.
Yeah, it's listing.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not a point.
I Thank you. I
Confirm or deny before you turn it in, or even after you turn it in, until it's graded.
think our tests are all in.
And we got roughly about 20 minutes. But there was a handout I wanted you guys to pick up when you turned your test in, but I didn't want to say it 20 times while you guys were doing it. So did anybody not grab the handout, I will bring it to you. Okay, so this practice FRQ that I wanted you to pick up transitions us into curve sketching. And the reason why I wanted to give it to you as you finished your test is because you should feel pretty good about parts A through D. And E is what's unique about curve sketching. So I need y'all to do parts A, B, C, and D. And then I will show you how all of that comes together so that we can do part D. So with the time you have left, with the time you have left, please go ahead and answer A through D.
And you're welcome to work with your table partners on that.
This part's not part of the test. I will be aiming to have test grades in the gradebook before the weekend. As always, we have a scale that we try to use, but it is always dependent on the scores. So make sure that you please don't talk about the test to your friends that haven't taken it yet. And again, if there was something on today's test, you know, not just a harder question, but like if you didn't feel confident about knowing when something's concave down, or you were not confident on when to find relative maxes, or you were not confident on finding decreasing intervals, that type of stuff's going to carry over into curve sketching now. You have to be able to do that same stuff. So make sure that you clear those things up. This is a B week, so I will not see you again until Monday. So you got plenty of time to do the first four parts of those. And we will only have two full classes before your curve sketching quiz. So it's important to make sure that you are on the right track there. Now, of course, on this practice FRQ, don't use your calculator to get any answer. But if you'd like to check your work for A through D, you could graph it in your calculator and make sure that the real graph is matching up to the answers you get from doing it by hand. Okay.